Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about midpoint theorem. As name signifies, this theorem is about midpoint of the sides of the triangle. For example, if we have a triangle ABC, and D and E are the midpoints of side AB and AC respectively, then this theorem says that the line segment joining the midpoint of any two side is parallel to the third side, this one, and half of the third side. So hope it's clear. It means what? We have to prove that BE parallels to BC and DE equals to half of BC. We have to prove this one. Clear? So for this, we have to construct some part of the triangle and then we prove this one. So for construction, we extend the line BE up to F and join CF such that CF is parallel to DB. This one. So this is to do the construction. Now, during the proof of this thing, as we have already discussed, that this line and this line in construction, we need that line CF is parallel to DB, or you can say complete BA. Clear? So this is the construction part. Now how we proof of this thing is, first we take these two triangles, and in these two triangles we try to prove that these two triangles are congruent. So for that we can write down in triangle ADE and triangle EFC. In triangle EFC, as we know from construction that these two lines are parallel, it means what? Angle DAE, angle DAE, this angle DAE is equal to angle ECF. Why? Because they are alternate interior angles. Okay? So these two angles are equal. As we know that E is midpoint, it means what? AE equals to EC. AE equals to EC. Why? E is midpoint is given. E is midpoint, that's given. So these two point, these two sides are equal. And once again, this angle and this angle, very common thing, it's the angle AEB. Angle AEB equals to angle AEB equals to angle CEF. Why? It's a vertically opposite angle. No? It means what? Triangles are congruent. AEB congruent to triangle EFC by angle. angle, side, angle concept. Now, once we can say that these two triangles are equal, it means what? The line BE equals to EF by simplicity. BE equals to EF by CPCD. So you can say E is a midpoint. You can say E is a midpoint of the line DF. This is the first part of the theorem. Now, from this movement, we can say that these two parts are equal. Also, we can say from here, AD equals to CF. AD equals to CF. From again, it's a by CPCD. So, what we have, we have that these two sides are equal, one, and these two parts are equal. Also, we can say these things are equal. These things, means AD and CF, are equal to each other by CPCD. And we already know that this D is the midpoint of side AB. It's given. Now, we come to the rectangle part, that parallelogram. As we know, C in this case, in ABCD, I am rubbing this side so that you can prove the remaining thing. Now see, in case of in quadrilateral BCFD, we can say that this is parallel to this one. In BCFD, we can say BD parallels to CF. BD parallels to CF, number one. And we also know that these two are equal and these two are equal. So we can say we know that AB equals to BD and this AD is also equal to CF, we proved previously. So what does it mean? It means that BD equals to CF. Now in a quadrilateral, one pair or opposite pair is equal and parallel. So we can say that this is a parallelogram. Therefore, we can say that BCFD is a parallelogram. This one is proved. Once we are able to prove that this is a parallelogram, it means what? We can say that BC equals to FD. BC equals to FD. But we know that E is the midpoint of FD. We already know, so we can say right for FB it's a BE plus EF, DE plus EF, or as we know that both are equal to each other, so we can in place of this we can write down 2DE. Clear? Therefore, DE equals to half of BC. So here we can prove that first this part is half of this one, and though this is a parallelogram, it means what? DE also parallels to BC because it's a parallelogram, so you can write down. Therefore, DE is also parallels to BC because it's a parallelogram, part of a parallelogram. BCFD is a parallelogram. So this is the proof of the midpoint theorem. Hope you are able to understand this proof of midpoint theorem. Depending upon midpoint theorem, we have two more theorems. those are converse of midpoint theorem. Converse of midpoint theorem, and this converse says just opposite to the midpoint theorem. In midpoint theorem, what we say that if we join two midpoints of two sides of a triangle, then that line segment is half of the third side and parallel to the third side. This is the midpoint theorem. And in this case, in case of converse theorem, we just say the reverse one. Reverse one says that if the line drawn from the midpoint of one side, see, and this proof is as same as midpoint theorem, proof is not required, but simply we'll say that if I am changing the name here, it's a PQR is a triangle and X is a midpoint. Clear? So it's converse of midpoint theorem says that the line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle, and this line is parallel to this one, parallel to the third side always bisect the second side, always bisect the second side, means what? That Y is the midpoint of PR. This is the converse of theorem. Once again, I am saying that if we draw a line from midpoint of a side and parallel to the second side, this line bisect the third side. This is the converse of the midpoint theorem. The same of the midpoint theorem is simply just opposite one. So here the proof is same, that we have to prove. First we extend this one and then prove that these two sides are same. Now third one is your theorem on intercepts. In intercept theorem, it says that if three lines are parallel to each other, clear? Three lines are parallel to each other, say it's L, M, and N, these lines are L, M, and N, these three lines are parallel to each other, a transversal line P, this line P, hope it's visible in video. It's not visible. So this line is your P. A transversal line P cuts the parallel line. Theorem says that then any other line cutting them also makes equal intercept. It means what? That these makes equal intercept. So any other line which is your Q cuts at different points and they make equal intercept. Suppose this is your point A, point B, and point C, and this one is your point B, point E, and point F. What we need to prove? It is a little bit confusing one. So if once we know that what is proof, that is easier for you. It's given that AB, this part, is equals to BC part. These three lines are parallel. AB equals to BC. So what we have to prove? We have to prove that AB equals prove that this one DE, it's given that AB equals to BC. Clear? And what we will prove? It's that DE equals to EF. Now this we have to prove. Now there is a construction part. So through E we draw a line R which is parallel to the line P
to meet L at G and line L at N. We draw a line
which is parallel to this line B and must passes through the line. Must passes through the point E. Clear? Hope this one is clear to you.
In this case, this line, give the name is R. This line is R.
This line cuts the parallel part at G and H. This is your point G, this is your point H.
You must go through the book part also, because I am taking this as it is book, not the previous inventory, but this as it is book, so that you can understand clearly.
Now, this is your construction part. Now, how we have to prove? It's given that this C, this one, A, B, E, G, in figure A, B, E, G, this AB is parallel to AB parallel to GE from construction, and BE parallels to AZ. It's given AZ parallels to BE. This is from construction, and this is given. It means what? ABG EZ. AB EZ is a parallelogram. ABEZ is a parallelogram. Now, as we know that AB equals to EZ, because of, we know from the parallelogram, we know that opposite sides are equal. Once we are able to prove that these two lines are parallel from construction, this is your parallelogram. So we can say that AB equals to GE, because in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Number one. Then once again we will prove that, similarly we will prove that BCFE
BCHE. This in B, C, H, E, we again similarly can say that BC is parallel to EH from construction. BC parallels to EH from construction. From construction, and it's given that CH parallels to BE. CH parallels to BE. It's given. So BCHE is a parallelogram. BCHE is a parallelogram. Hope this one is clear to you. BCHE is a parallelogram. Let me adjust the camera a little bit. Now it's good.
BCHE is a parallelogram. Now, once we can say that BCHE is a parallelogram, it means what? BC equals to EH. Need not to confuse class. In this, we are using this part. Clear? And in this, we are using this part. Clear? So,
BC equals to EH and CH equals to B, that is the part of the proof. Now, once we are able to see proof that these two sides are equal to each other, means what? So, in triangle this and this, triangle DEG and triangle EFHE or EFH, whatever you can say, we can prove that triangles are congruent. And once triangles are congruent, it means DE equals to EF. I am writing this part. Now we observe that triangles are congruent. So in triangle DEG and triangle EFH or FHE, can you write? Follow the order. If it's a FHE, we can say that angle DEG equals to angle FEH. Why? It's a vertically opposite angles. It's a vertically opposite angle. Number one, we already proved that this side GE equals to EH, side GE, this one is equals to EH. How? From that we previously already proved that GE equals to EH, because we know that AB equals to BC, GE equals to AB, we previously proved GE equals to AB and EH equals to BC, and AB equals to BC. We know that AB equals to BC, and also we can say that AB equals to GE. We already proved that AB equals to GE, and we already proved that BC equals to EH. BC equals to EH. It means what? These two sides are equal. These two sides are equal. These two angles are equal. Since these two lines are parallel to each other, so angle DGE, angle DGE equals to angle DGE equals to angle EHF. How? It's a alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. So we can say that triangle DEG congruent to triangle FHE by angle side angle congruency. And once we are able to prove that triangles are congruent, it means we can say that DE equals to EF. DE equals to EF by CBC. This is your intercept theorem. It means what? That if these two are equal, then these two must be equal. That is why we are proving this one. Hope up to this it's clear to you, theorem is clear to you. We discuss some question in next video.